The process of creating any optic with Plano surfaces involves several key steps: cutting the substrate into the desired shape, grinding the surface to ensure the two planes are parallel or lie at the desired angle, beveling the edges of the optic to prevent chipping during processing, and polishing the surfaces to achieve the specified surface quality. Once an optic has been designed by our engineers, the raw material is ordered into our warehouse. Substrates can be in the form of a flat plate, pieces of material that are already machined to roughly the shape of the finished optic that are called blanks, or the substrate can be a crystal boule. Our colored glass filters begin as 6.5-inch square flat plates of glass that must be cut to the shape of the finished optic. The Bridgeport coring machines can drill round optics out of flat plates. Prior to coring, the glass must be blocked. During this process, a metal block is placed on a hot plate and wax is melted onto the surface. A plate of scrap glass is then pressed into the wax to secure it to the plate. Next, the wax is spread over the scrap glass and the filter glass is pressed firmly on top. The blocked filter glass is then mounted in the bridge port for coring. A diamond core drill is lowered onto the plate until it drills through the filter glass and into the sheet of scrap glass, ensuring a cleanly cut circle. These coring machines can drill round blanks with diameters from 1/4 inch to 2 inches. Alternatively, our two Kulik and Soffa dicing machines can cut flat plates up to 5 millimeters thick into rectangles or squares. The glass plate is blocked on a large piece of tape and mounted in the dicing machine. The dicing process typically takes an hour. When complete, the diced glass is simply peeled off of the blocking tape. After the filter glass has been cut to the appropriate shape, it is removed from the block. The scrap glass plate and any excess filter glass are discarded. The pieces are transferred to a large circular block in preparation for grinding. Each round glass piece is pressed firmly onto the surface of the block to remove any air pockets, as these can tilt the glass during grinding or polishing and result in an uneven thickness across the optic. The blocked optics are ground in one of our surface grinding machines to adjust the thickness and to ensure that the two surfaces are parallel. The grinding wheel has diamond grit metal bonded to the surface and rotates at 5,000 revolutions per minute to quickly remove material from the pieces of filter glass. After the first round of grinding, the paralleled pieces of glass are removed from the block and placed in a rack for cleaning. A mechanical arm on the Crest 5-bath ultrasonic cleaning machine hooks into the handle on the rack and dips it into each bath in a computer-controlled sequence. After cleaning, the glass is mounted to a holder, dipped in water, and pressed against a rotating, diamond-plated bronze cup to create a 45-degree bevel. The beveled edge protects the glass blank from chipping during processing. The cleaned and beveled glass blanks will be reblocked and go through several more rounds of grinding using progressively finer grits or loose abrasives to further adjust the thickness of the glass and the parallelism of the surfaces. Optics can be blocked for polishing using pitch, wax, cement, or a method called optical contacting. Optically contacting two surfaces together requires both surfaces to be very flat and very clean. Once the two surfaces are matched, an interference fringe will then be visible. By applying pressure to the edge of the top placed optic, bonding will occur. This method is used for optics that have stringent thickness and parallelism specifications. The blocked filter glass is loaded onto the spindle of one of our conventional overarm polishing machines and rotates over a polishing tool lubricated with cerium oxide polishing compound. The position of the plate on the tool is adjusted until the desired surface quality is achieved. The polishing process typically takes about 4 to 6 hours. For large volume fabrication, Thorlabs also has speed fan machines, which grind or polish both sides of an optic simultaneously. Thorlabs uses two different sizes of these machines, with one grinding and one polishing machine in each size. Two smaller SpeedFam 9B machines can hold up to 140 1-inch diameter round optics or 32 2-inch square optics in a single run. In contrast, two larger SpeedFam 16B machines can grind or polish up to 325 1-inch diameter round optics or 80 2-inch square optics in a single run. In the two polishing machines, optics are sandwiched between two polyurethane polishing pads. A cerium oxide polishing compound is pumped into the system through tubing connected to holes in each pad's inner surface. Once the fabrication process is complete, the transmission of the filter is checked. This process is part of our in-process quality control and occurs before the optic is sent to the coating lab or to our final quality control lab.